All right. On Twitter, Matt Paulson is asking, is there a website online that gives you a rough estimate of a podcast's audience? So how can I find out how many listeners a podcast has, or at least an estimate? There's a few different ways you can figure some of this out, and I thought I'd make a video and show you how. To start, we'll use my podcast as an example. This is Build Your SaaS, and this is a show that we don't publish very regularly anymore. So I'm just going to show you all of our stats. As you can see, we had a nice run when we were publishing weekly. So if we look at how many downloads our episodes get these days, it's about 3,000 to 7,000, it looks like, when we publish new episodes. And we estimate that we have about 1,300 people still subscribed to the podcast. So these are the analytics we know. So now that we know the real stats, let's go and try out some of these podcast audience or podcast listener estimation tools. The first one I'll show you is Listen Notes. So you can search for a podcast here. We'll search for Build Your SaaS. There it is. And this is going to give the podcast a score, listen score and global rank. Basically, the listen score is a metric that shows the estimated popularity of this podcast compared to other RSS-based podcasts on a scale from 0 to 100. So in our case, we get a score of 44 out of 100, and it ranks us in the top 1% out of all of the podcasts that have ever been published. I think in terms of signal, listen score is more interesting than global rank. And there's other interesting data you can see here about how often they publish an episode. It's saying about every 33 days, who the hosts are, how many episodes they've done, the audience for the podcast. This is probably pretty close, actually, just looking at our global United States, United Kingdom, Canada, Australia. It's saying US, Australia, so it's a little bit off in terms of what the real stats say, but pretty close there. It's also interesting to compare a podcast to other podcasts in that category. So we could choose my friend Arvid Kahl's Bootstrap Founder. So he's got a listen score of 38 and top 2%. Let's see how other tools estimate the audience for both of these podcasts. So the next tool I'd like to show you is Podnews. They have a search engine up here where you can search for a podcast. And there's actually lots of great data on here. So I searched Build Your SaaS. You can see down here in podcasts, it opens up this information and it's pulling in some really interesting signals. So how many ratings we have? We have 168 ratings. That's an interesting signal. And also OP3 analytics. So OP3 is this optional service people can use that make their stats public. And so in April 2024, this show reached an audience of 991 people with 1,500 downloads. If you get invited to guest on a podcast, I think searching for them on Podnews is a good first step. Now let's compare what we're seeing here to the Bootstrap Founder. And again, so in their case, their public stats are showing in April 2024, they reached an audience of 14,000 with nearly 20,000 downloads. You can actually even click on this. And if they're using OP3, it will give you their actual stats. So you'll be able to take a look here and actually see the performance of their episodes. You could even see when they've interviewed somebody, how did those episodes perform, their top countries, top US metros, top Canadian regions, all sorts of interesting stats here. Again, this is only if they're using OP3 public stats, but you'll be able to find out if they're using OP3 by searching for their podcast on Podnews. Another tool for determining how many listeners a podcast has is Rephonic. It's a paid tool, but they do have a free search. You can use rephonic.com/search. So let's look for Build Your SaaS. And we get, again, some information. How many episodes do they have? Last episode was 16 days ago. You can apparently upgrade and get information on how many Spotify followers they have, how many monthly listeners. In this case, they're using OP3. So if you've already had access to that through just searching for the podcast on Podnews and opening up their OP3 dashboard, you don't really need that. It'll also give you information on their YouTube channel. And in this case, you can see their subscribers if you upgrade, but you could also just visit the YouTube channel. And in our case, you can see we have about 23,000 subscribers. So another interesting signal there. And you can see how many ratings they have on the various podcast platforms. There's also a listing of the charts. So we're number 87 in Italy for business marketing. Let's search for Bootstrapped Founder. And so here you can see the charts for Bootstrapped Founder. You can see how many ratings Arvid has on Apple and Spotify. And you can also go to their YouTube channel and see how many subscribers they have there. If you're just interested in seeing where they chart, you can search for them in a tool called Chartable. So Bootstrapped Founder. And this will pull up some of that information, how many ratings they have, and then their rank history on the Apple podcast charts. I should also mention that there are some podcast players that will show you how many subscribers and listens a podcast has, but these represent a minority of listeners. So Castbox and Podcast Addict both do this. For example, for our podcast, this is Castbox, and it's probably about 1% of our downloads. But if I search Castbox for a show, and it'll say we have 593 people on the platform subscribed and that we've had 20,000 plays. And I think if you're trying to figure out if it's worth it for you to appear on a podcast as a guest, a general guideline could be if the podcast is getting more than 1,100 downloads per episode, that's better than 80% of all podcasts. If it's 3,200 downloads per episode, that's better than 90% of all shows. And it goes on from there. And if we go back to our stats here for my show, you can see that our averages are in this range. In the first 30 days, we get about 2,800 downloads. And I would say, for myself at least, and depending on the category, if a podcast is getting over 2,000 downloads per episode, it's probably worth guesting on that show, depending on what you want to get out of it. So that's my answer to the question, how do I know how popular a podcast is? If you're interested in trying Transistor for your own podcast and getting stats like this, head over to transistor.fm and click that 14-day free trial button. You can even migrate your existing podcast over to us, and we'll start tracking your stats like this. Thanks.